dream, my bags on the shelf. I find my seat in the middle and plan to keep to myself. The pilot comes on, says there's been a delay. Then I sigh, buckle up, and prepare to wait. There's a middle-aged woman on my right by the window. No ring on her finger, maybe divorced or a widow. She's drafting an email, and from where I am seated, I can sign out that shit. So of course I'm gonna read it. It said, "Dear McCracken, this is already great. Dude's got a pen and pal and a killer last name." She opens with an inside joke, and she's hoping to set a casual tone. Her words carefully chosen. She was so sure that her weeks spent in Houston would dry, but then a face from her past quickly changed all of that. The trip was for business, and she's used to the travel, but this time she's not ready to head back to Seattle. "Dear McCracken, I'd rather be off this plane. I can't admit the half of it that I want to say. Do I pretend to push you away? I'm jet lagging, McCracken, and I'll give you your space." I can tell by the abuse of the backspace key, there's a hard bounce on how her words are perceived. She's retyped that fourth paragraph four times, swinging the tone back and forth until she's so satisfied that he knows that even though her passive efforts, there's an air of regret, but not enough to reverse. I'm stunned, there I sit, completely convinced that once you grow old, you stop dealing with this. The uncertain, the hurting, the feeling like dirt when things don't work out by the fall of the curtain. She had said, "I was off, ready to go," and I am sad for the passion and the McCracken he might never know. "Dear McCracken, I'd rather be off this plane. I can't admit the half of it that I want to say. Do I pretend to push you away? I'm jet lagging, McCracken, and I'll give you your. Dear McCracken, I'm keeping this on my chest. I said a lot of things, but none of them what I meant. Do I pretend? Do I try to forget? I'm jet lagging, McCracken, and I wish you the best."
She loved you.